Maria, and today we are going to learn how to add a background image or color to your entire WordPress site. There are various ways to set a background image in WordPress. These methods usually change based on the location you want to put the image. For instance, you may decide that you'd like to have a background image to remain the same throughout your entire website. On the other hand, it's possible you'd rather find a way to show unique background images for all of your pages. Whatever you desire for your site's background, Kinsta is here to help. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in this video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's get started. Theme developers decide the fate of a site's background capabilities. WordPress has a functionality built into the core, but a theme developer could turn it off, leaving you with no dashboard setting to turn it on. If at any point in the following tutorials, you find that your theme is the reason you're lacking a custom background option, consider the following steps to make a quick fix of it. The main custom background support for WordPress gets handled by the functions.php file. Open that file and insert the following code if it's missing. Keep in mind that the element actually activating the background support is the addThemeSupport function with everything in it. That code turns the background feature on in the WordPress dashboard. It's also possible to add a default background image for the entire theme through the functions.php file. Simply go to the area from the previous code with a default image value and add the image's URL like you see here. This is a quick and easy way to turn on custom backgrounds within the WordPress dashboard. Having said that, we recommend changing the theme if it doesn't have background support in the first place. The removal of the custom background feature could have its own purpose, or maybe the theme developer found it was causing too many problems with the design. If your theme offers the capability to add a custom background image, and many do, it makes it much easier for you. To begin, go to your WordPress dashboard and click on Appearance and then Customize. That brings you to the WordPress Theme Customizer with customization settings on the left and a website preview on the right. Here, find and click on the Background tab. As an alternative, if you can select Appearance, then Background, you can use it for a more direct route to this setting. The Background Customization area manages the background elements for your entire website. Click the Select Image button to proceed. In the Select Image window, choose an image that will fit well as a background for your brand and website styling. In general, a neutral color pattern with a black or white or gray shade usually helps to ensure that most of your text and content still looks good with the background behind it. Once you select your image, click on the Choose Image button to move on. The background you implemented now appears in the website preview. See if your content still stands out and looks presentable with the chosen image. Sometimes you may find that you need to either completely swap out the background or change things like text or link colors. A small thumbnail of the background also shows up in the settings panel, showing you that the image has been implemented. A few additional settings are available for WordPress backgrounds, including the preset field. Click on the preset field to change the formatting of the image using preset designs and alignments. You can choose from the following presets. Default. This is usually the same as repeat, but it may depend on your theme. The default setting generally works best, but it depends on the image being used. Fill screen. This setting stretches the image to ensure that all parts of the screen get covered, even if it means cropping the image so it overflows off the screen. It works well for many high-resolution images, but could cause blurring with low-resolution images. Fit to screen. This maintains the original photo's aspect ratio and attempts to use that ratio to fit the current screen image. It does a good job of keeping the image close to its original state, but may not cover all the background area. Repeat. This uses parts of the fill screen function, expanding and stretching the image, but it also repeats the image when it can't successfully cover the entire screen. For patterns, this usually looks great. Custom. This setting gives you the most control over the background, offering several options to customize the WordPress background image size, like how it repeats on the page, stretches, or moves as the user scrolls. There's no rule as to which of the presets work best because images come in different sizes, resolutions, and details. Therefore, you're best off starting with the default preset and then testing each of the other presets to see which one looks best for your background image. The Fit to Screen preset doesn't quite do it for this image, mainly because the original image is much longer than it is wide, leaving a significant amount of space to the right. I could change the image position to the center, but it would most likely leave white space on the sides. The next setting to consider is the Image Position tool. Click the arrows to move your background image around, adjusting the orientation to either place the image's focus towards the center or filling the screen. Much like the preset setting, the Image Position tool requires a process of guessing and checking your work, as the original image and its contents dictate how it looks. Next up, there's a checkbox field to make the background image scroll with page. With this box checked, the background image sticks to the foreground content and scrolls along with the user as that person moves up or down a page. Unchecking that box tends to change the background's image's general orientation, yet its dominant feature is to tell the background to remain static while the user scrolls down the page. The foreground content items, like the products in this instance, glide over the background image, creating an attractive effect. When opting for something besides the custom preset, you don't get that many additional settings to configure. However, choosing the custom preset opens up several other fields to consider. For example, you can choose to fill the screen or fit the screen and then combine that with a repeated or non-repeated background image, combining the preset's elements from before. And you still get the scroll with page option. See if using the original image without any edits or settings is possible. Sometimes the original photo is a near perfect match to be used as a background, so why mess with what's already ready to go? However, its size may also be too big for your website, or maybe the aspect ratio isn't quite the right fit. Regardless, we suggest experimenting with this setting to figure out if it's right for you. Once you decide upon your perfect background settings, click on the Publish button to render the changes on your website. Go to the front end of your website to see the background in action. The homepage is a wonderful place to start. You'll notice that the header area and welcome image don't have backgrounds. That's because the welcome image at the top of the site is already covering the entire horizontal part of the screen as a full screen hero image. As for the header and menu, you'll learn how to configure those backgrounds in some of the following tutorials. Keep in mind that the general custom WordPress background activates on every page and post of your website. It's a global feature for those who want a quick way to brand their site and add some flair. For example, going to the shop page on this site reveals the background behind the product selection. The process of activating a background color on your entire website isn't much different from when you're turning on a background image. Start by going to Appearance and then Background in the dashboard. Then look for the Background Color field. Click the Select Color button to open up more settings to choose and switch out different colors for your background. The color panel provides multiple options for you to decide on a color. The first is by typing in or pasting in a color code. All colors have unique color codes, and you can find these colors and their associated codes with a quick internet search. The other option is to click around the color panel to find the perfect color for the background. They even have common color swatches towards the bottom of the panel if you'd rather take one of the simpler colors. To activate a background color, make sure the color is selected and showing in the Select Color preview. You should see the color background in the WordPress Customizer view. If not, that most likely means you have an image background installed that's overriding the color background. All you have to do to reveal the color background is click the Remove button underneath the background image preview. Now the color appears throughout the entirety of your site behind the content, much like you would with an image background. It's prudent to look through your website to ensure that all text, images, and links are still visible with the new background. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.